This video demonstrates how to update the operating system for a Campbell Scientific data logger, in this case, a CR1000XE. The data logger operating system, or OS, is the collection of instructions and processes necessary for the data logger to function. It can be thought of as a library. When a data logger is programmed, it refers to this library for the information necessary to complete its tasks. Campbell Scientific is continually adding new features to the datalogger operating systems. As new features become available, I may choose to update the OS. These features are listed in the OS revision text on the OS downloads page. Today, I'll be using a CR1000XE. The procedure I demonstrate is similar for other CRBasic dataloggers, such as the CR6. The latest operating systems can be downloaded from the Campbell Scientific website, www.campbellsci.com. I need to be logged into campbellsci.com to download files. I need to create a free account if I'm not registered. Navigate to the Operating Systems for Datologgers category. Locate the datalogger model, a CR1000XE in this case. If using a CR6 Wi-Fi or CR6 RF400 series, the OS download will also include operating systems for the Wi-Fi or radio daughter board, which are separate from the main data logger OS. These daughter board OSs have a .iobj extension. I can check if my data logger has the latest Wi-Fi or radio operating system in the status table. The procedure for updating the .iobj files are included in the OS download. Click Download Now. The executable file is downloaded to my downloads directory. Double-click the file. This will place the os.obj and any .iobj files in the C Campbell Sci Lib operating systems folder. Running the downloaded file will also update the datalogger support files, such as the help and precompiler for the CRBasic editor. In this video, I'll use the Send OS tab in the Device Configuration utility to update the OS on a local datalogger. This is a good method to reset the datalogger back to factory defaults. I always do this when I begin a new project with a datalogger that may have been used previously. For this method, I need to connect my computer to the datalogger directly, not over a telecommunications link. Launch the Device Configuration utility. Select the datalogger from the list. I'm using a CR1000XE. I've already installed the USB driver and connected the USB cable from my computer to the datalogger. Some older CRBasic dataloggers will also need 12-volt power. Go directly to the Send OS tab. This method of sending an OS will delete all data, settings, and programs. If I want to easily restore the datalogger settings and programs, I have the option to use the Backup Datalogger feature. Make sure the right COM port is selected. Connect. Go to the Backup menu. Choose Backup Datalogger. This will backup the datalogger settings and programs. Click Next to step through the procedure. Click Finish. If I have data saved on the datalogger that needs to be retained, I will retrieve that data using the Data Collection tab before continuing. Now disconnect. Now that my datalogger is backed up, I can go back to the Send OS tab. All data and programs will be lost at this point. The datalogger will be set back to factory default. For older CRBasic dataloggers, such as the CR1000 or CR3000, I would need to remove power from the logger. Not cycling power for these older loggers is one of the most common errors people make. The OS update will not begin until Device Configuration utility receives a sync byte that the datalogger sends when it powers up. Cycling power is not necessary for newer dataloggers, such as the CR1000XE or CR6. Start. Navigate to the new OS. It will be in the C Campbell Sci Lib Operating Systems folder. Select the OS file and click Open. Click OK when a window pops up about avoiding conflicts with the local server. This is where older CRBasic dataloggers would get powered back up to send a sync byte to the Device Configuration utility. The time it takes to send the OS has been sped up for this demonstration. It will take a few minutes for the datalogger to configure the operating system. While this is happening, the activity and power LEDs will flash. Wait until the activity LED stops blinking and the power LED is on solid before proceeding. When it's complete, click OK. Now I'll connect to the datalogger again so I can restore its configuration. Select the backup menu, then restore a datalogger. The last backup saved is automatically selected. I can choose a different file if I wish. Click Next. The settings are restored first, followed by the program files. Click Finish. Connect to the datalogger again. I can see the operating system version and some of the restored settings. I'll go to File Control next, where I can see that the same program is running as when I backed up the datalogger. And that's it. Using the backup and restore features of the device configuration utility streamlines getting the datalogger up and running after a full factory reset and sending a new OS. Please contact a Campbell Scientific technical support engineer to discuss your specific application and to get assistance with sending an operating system to the datalogger.